We're still waiting to get confirmation. I see we've got pictures of aid crews at the sea. Boats are searching underneath that bridge. We've heard as many as three cars may have gone down with the bridge. We've had no word on casualties, although we do have reporters stationed at area hospitals waiting to get information. Information is very slow in coming, even though it's been 2 hours since this happened. They're still busy searching the scene. Aid crews lined up, helicopters overhead. We're just starting to get to the dark now. They had daylight up until probably about 10 minutes ago, and now things are starting to get darker. So we have no word on the casualties. This is a major catastrophe for the state just as far as infrastructure. The I-5 runs north-south through our state, and it's the main line of commuting from Seattle. It goes up to Vancouver, B.C., and this is kind of a rural area in Mount Vernon where this bridge went down the Skagit River. It's a farming community, but this roadway is a main one for us. The governor is heading to the scene along with the State Patrol, and we're just waiting to get more information about what's happened as far as any loss of life.
Nancy, just looking at some news wires coming through, talking about, I just wanted to address the issue of safety. Now, I understand that this bridge isn't considered structurally deficient, but it is listed as being functionally obsolete, meaning that its design is outdated. And I'm just looking at some data from the American Society of Civil Engineers, which said that more than a quarter of Washington State's bridges were considered structurally deficient or functionally obsolete. Have there been any concerns about safety, particularly when it comes to this bridge, do you know of?
Well, our Department of Transportation had a list of about 156 bridges across the state that needed to be looked at. We do have plenty of old bridges here. This one was built in 1953, but it is a major roadway. And so it is being inspected, and we do have reports. We had a caller saying that we believe that a oversized load may have struck. This is a steel girder bridge, struck the corner, and after he saw that accident, the bridge went down. We're still waiting for confirmation on that. But when it comes to whether or not this bridge was structurally deficient, state DOT is doing a examination even as we speak, but says that there were no immediate concerns about the safety of this bridge.